So our oceans remain quite a mystery for many of us, but we do know that they are in trouble. We've seen major declines in the number of sharks and fishes over the last 50 years. So the question is, how do we halt and reverse those declines? So we need to understand the role that sharks, for instance, play in maintaining healthy ecosystems. So the exciting thing about the Pangaea initiative is that we're going to the most shallow of ecosystems, where historically sharks and trevally and jacks have been abundant, and we're understanding how they contribute to the health of those ecosystems. And we're doing that through a process of catch and release sampling, where we collect a fish, we take its condition, we measure it, we take a small tissue sample that will tell us what it eats, how it's behaving, and then release it back into the ocean. We're also dropping cameras and allow us to look at how many sharks are there, how many individuals of other species, and where sharks are few, does that actually change the structure of those fish communities? And what are the implications for the reef? So what we can tell from the footage that we already have is some locations are quite sharky, lots of grey reef sharks, black tips and so on. And in those places, there's a complete different behavior of the other fish around. Whereas in places that the sharks are less abundant, on the Great Barrier Reef, for instance, what we then see is that that next tier down of fish are much more engaged and active and dominant. So what we know from previous research done by Dr. Shanta Barley, a postdoc here at University of Western Australia, is that the behavior of fish changes dramatically as a function of how many sharks are around. And the question is, what are the knock-on effects for reef health overall?